Hi, and welcome to our program From Embryo to Chick. My name is Jeannette Beranger, and I'm the Senior Program Manager for the Livestock Conservancy, a national nonprofit dedicated to the conservation of rare livestock and poultry breeds. Today's topic is Playing Peekaboo, where we will explore the embryonic cycle of chicken eggs. We will then use that knowledge in our homemade egg candlers to see how many eggs are fertile in our incubator. We will talk about the importance of keeping records for what is happening with the eggs and the next steps we will be taking as we near hatching time. So sit back and let's get started with the wonderful film by the Poultry CRC and Axis Studio of Australia about the embryonic cycle of a chicken. I don't have a powerful flashlight to create a candler, so I'll try to make do with what I have around the house. You might be surprised to find there's a great egg candler right in your own back pocket. So let's get started.
So today we're going to candle some eggs and see if they're fertile or not. I'm building on some of the ideas that Victoria had for egg candler. I don't have a big flashlight around, but I do have one of these little LED lights that are pretty strong. And the other thing I have is my cell phone. And so if I go to the flashlight function, I get a pretty strong flashlight. And so with the flashlight, I took some toilet paper rolls like Victoria did. I cut a small piece and put it over the flashlight, and that actually makes a pretty darn good egg candler. The other option I have is, again, with this micro flashlight, but I want to have it in the center of this tube, so I just took a piece of paper towel and stuck it in there. A pretty good egg candler too. So I think we're gonna maybe go with the cell phone candler because the light seems to be brighter than my little micro LED. And so let's start taking a look at some eggs.
Now we're gonna candle some 12-day-old eggs and see if we can tell which ones are fertile and which ones are not. If you remember from the video we just watched, the chicks at day 12 are well-formed and should be taking up a large portion of the egg. Here we have two types of chickens inside my tabletop incubator that we're going to take a look at. The white eggs are Crevecoeur eggs and the brown eggs are Dominique eggs. A check mark means we think it is fertile and growing, and an X means we think the chick has not developed in the egg. So here we go and see if your notes align with what we think is happening with the egg.
So now we're going to try and candle some eggs from my incubator that has Dominiques and Crevecoeur eggs, and we'll do about 10 each. And what I want you to do is take a guess. Could it be fertile or not fertile? And we'll give our best guess after. This one is a non-fertilized egg that I just got out of the coop. And so with that, we'll start with the Crevecoeurs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Now we'll do some Dominique eggs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. How many of those do you think are fertile?
You want to make sure that you make note of how many eggs you throw away and how many you keep. You also want to keep track of how many eggs you keep that actually hatch. When hatching is over, we will open up the eggs that did not hatch and try to figure out what went wrong so that we can try and improve how we incubate the eggs the next go round and make things better. In the meantime, it's day 12 and we have to start thinking about preparing for hatching. Day 18 is when we transition from our first stage incubation to our second stage, which is hatching. On day 18, we will no longer be turning the eggs since the chicks are getting ready to make their way out of their eggs. The temperature must drop slightly and the humidity must increase so that the chicks don't stick to the inside of the eggshell. Listen very closely now, this is really, really important. Do not open the incubator unless it's absolutely necessary at this point. Each time you open it, the humidity drops, and if a chick is in the middle of hatching, this could be a big problem and it could get stuck in the shell. Chicks can survive on what's in their egg yolk for the first several days of life, so even if you see chicks out of the shell and walking around, please, for the sake of the other chicks still trying to hatch, leave everyone alone and undisturbed in the incubator for the first couple of days of hatching. I usually pull the chicks from the incubator and put them in the brooder about 2 to 3 full days after the eggs started hatching. If all goes well, you are patient, and you have followed all the instructions, you should have a brooder full of healthy chicks to take care of. Well, that ends today's segment on playing peekaboo. In our following lessons, we will be learning more about embryos and the anatomy of eggs, choosing the right chickens for your home, building a brooder for your new chicks and caring for them, and visiting a chicken coop to see how to make your chickens feel at home. This program would not be possible without the support of our sponsors, including Tractor Supply Company and the Manton Foundation. I want to give special thanks to Premier One for providing the Barato Tabletop Incubator and to Hamilton Rare Breeds Foundation for the GQF Cabinet Incubator. For more information on other programs with the Livestock Conservancy and North Carolina Cooperative Extension, please visit our websites. Have a great day, and here's hoping the chicken projects you dream of come true.